Sam.
What?
Tell me a name of an animal.
Hannah.
What?
I mean, rephrase the question, Hannah.
Tell me a name of an animal which you find cute.
Of course, dolphin. They are very endearing.
It's a fish.
No, it's not a fish. It's a mammal. It gives birth to a baby dolphin and suckles to feed it.
Oh, I get it. I imagine how much they eat. They must eat a plethora of food.
They have two stomachs. One is for the storage of food and the other is for digestion.
My goodness. Imagine how they chomp food by their curved mouth. It must look very cute.
No, they never chew their food. Their teeth are only used to get their quarry. They gulp down their food.
I didn't know that. Don't they get hard underwater?
Yeah, they have exquisite skin, but they heal quickly. You know, I often see some videos where babies stand in front of the underwater aquarium, then the dolphins come, startle the babies. It's so droll.
Yeah, dolphins have a really good relationship with humans.
When I hear the news that the dolphins swim around happily in the ocean, I feel happy. But when I hear that the dolphins are brutally killed by some dishonest people, I get despondent.
Yeah. Okay, now you should learn some words.
Yes, we are going to learn lots of words today, so take a notebook and write them down. The first word is rephrase. Rephrase means to repeat something in a different and usually clearer way. The sentence is, could you rephrase your question, please? The second word is endearing. Endearing means something or someone extremely lovable or adorable. The sentence is, dolphin is an endearing creature. The third word is suckle. Suckle means breastfeed. The sentence is, the puppies went back to their mother to suckle. The fourth word is plethora. Plethora means a very large amount of something, especially an amount that is greater than you need, want, or can cope with. The sentence is, I have plethora of books, so I will donate some. The fifth word is chomp. Chomp means to chew or bite on something. Also, it means to chew food noisily. The sentence is, they were chomping burgers at a picnic. The sixth word is quarry. Quarry means an animal that is hunted. The sentence is, the lion was hunting for its quarry. It also means a place from which stone or other materials are extracted. The sentence is, this mountain was the site for a quarry. The seventh word is gulp. Gulp means to eat or drink something quickly by swallowing it in large amounts. The sentence is, she finished the remaining half of her drink in one gulp. It also means to breathe in a large amount of air very quickly. The sentence is, I took a gulp of air to steady myself. Word number 8. Exquisite. Exquisite means something that is beautiful and needs careful treatment because it's easily damaged. The sentence is, exquisite plants need to be kept in a greenhouse during the winter. It also describes feelings such as pleasure or pain that are extremely strong or qualities that are extremely good. The sentence is, the pain was quite exquisite. Word number 9. Startle. Startle means to surprise a person or animal. The sentence is, she was concentrating on her book and his voice startled her. Word number 10. Droll. Droll means funny but not in a way that you expect. The sentence is, I always loved his droll sense of humor. And the last word is despondent. Despondent means unhappy and with no hope. The sentence is, she started to feel despondent about ever finding a job. So that's all for today. I try to make videos that help everyone to memorize vocabulary. You will find a new playlist where I will try to cover all the words from Barron's High Frequency GRE Word List. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and thanks for watching.